We launched today.
Joe, you don't need to worry.
Well, I can't help it.
Hey. She's gonna be great. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
See you tonight?
Mm-hmm.
Bye.
Bye.
I'm sorry. Terminating a policy.
You can't be sorry. You don't even know what it means. You're a fucking robot.
I'm an interactive voice response system, or IVR. Since we're BFFs.
Ma'am, please speak to a fucking human.
No need to be rude.
Just need someone real.
Okay, I think we've heard enough.
Well, that was a shit show.
Ms. Rogers. Sorry, Roger. Let's talk about what we do have. We have a system with great voice recognition, giving us valuable data that we can use to then make improvements.
We have an expensive piece of crap that my customers are twittering about.
No, we're just experiencing a few hiccups in the personality department.
18 minutes on hold with Alexis, new voice of Waltrix. Condescending, rude, stupid, epic healthcare fail.
You're trendy, right? Come on, that's good.
Hey, Waltrix, I have cancer. If I wanted attitude, I'd go to Hot Topics.
Every system needs what we call tuning after its first launch.
Okay, who designed this offensive pseudo-person and unleashed it on my customers?
We did. You and I.
Excuse me?
You told me directly that you wanted to be the Southwest Airlines of the healthcare community.
Young people like subversive comedy.
You approved a personality matrix of sexy, irreverent, friendly, and fun. And a voice to match. I handled the call flow. Megan handled the language. And it's working. Call volume is up. Call center hours are down. Her stats are impeccable.
This is a success.
However, my customers hate her.
That's a different problem.
Roger, as team leader here at Oracle, it's my job to interpret the data.
Okay, you know what? Give me the nice voice.
What?
My customers want empathy. Give them empathy.
That is a great idea.
Empathy isn't possible. We could do sympathy.
What's the difference?
Empathy implies a shared experience. A system can't do that because people know it's a system.
Okay, who should I be listening to here?
I am the team leader here.
I'm the person that would have to build this new system.
I have a PhD in psycholinguistics.
Well, I am the client, and I'm pulling Alexis. She's dead. So I want to hear a new voice with an empathetic, professional personality in 1 week.
1 week is an unreasonable time horizon.
How's this time horizon? If you fail, I fail. If I fail, they fire me. If I'm fired, I have nothing but time. Time that I will use to destroy you. I will become a management consultant so that I can fire you wherever you may go. Do you understand me?
Roger that.
I'm sorry, what?
Nothing.
Damn it.
Nothing. Yeah, we got it. We are on it.
I'll call you in a week.
Looking forward to it. Thanks again, Roger.
Don't ask his, Gregory.
How can you say that we'll do it when we don't even know if it's possible, Greg?
Because I am a compulsive pleaser and a terrific liar. That is why I am the boss.
Dean, pull up the last 20 voices we heard for Alexis, please.
Are you seriously writing a pathetic essay?
Innovate or die.
These are the finalists.
Hi there. I'm Alexis. Let's take charge of your total body care plan. To hear details about our total body care plan, press 2.
Hey there. I'm Alexis. Let's take charge of your total body care plan. To hear more details about our total body care plan, press 2.
Total body care plan. I had it in rehearsal. Total body care plan. Hi, I'm Alexis. Hi, I'm Alexis. Let's take charge of your full, forgetful, total body care plan. Hi, I'm Alexis. Let's take charge of your total body care plan. To hear details about our total body care plan, press 2.
That's all we got. These are terrible, right?
Yeah.
I need a minute to think.
Tell her I'd say hi.
Parkside Concierge. How can I help?
This is room 1313.
Good afternoon, Mr. Larson. How was your meeting?
It was a disaster. Are you alone?
I have a guest waiting.
They're killing Alexis. I have to build an entirely new IVR by next week.
A week is plenty of time. I'm sure we can find you something. I'm so sorry. Give me one moment.
What if they fire me? Then you'll leave me and you'll find some chef who turns bacon into bubbles or liquid or gas or something.
Well, molecular gastronomy is a fascinating part of Chicago's foodie scene. However, I still prefer home cooking.
Inspire me.
Options by tonight. Megan, new language for the auditions at 6. And Joe, why don't you dig into the data and see where we're losing them?
Emily.
Yeah, I know. You just talked to her.
Should be the voice.
No. No, we need a pro.
You will still write the language. She will just be saying it.
Joe, amateurs have opinions. We can't.
This is just for the prototype.
Let's try it. Let's give her a call. See how it sounds.
Parkside Concierge, how can I help?
This is the guest in room 1313.
Hey, 1313. I'm alone, so you can talk dirty, but you have to talk fast.
No, Em, you're on speakerphone with Greg and the whole gang.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Joe seems to think you can help us with our problem here.
I'm sorry. Can you hold just a moment? Good afternoon, Mr. Ramsey. Welcome back. How can I help
you? We've got flowers. The toilets have flowers. There are flowers fucking everywhere.
But we don't have a florist.
This place is an overpriced Roach hotel with service like a county jail.
You're frustrated. I'm frustrated that we're not doing better by you. Please, what's the occasion?
A funeral. Apparently, $200 of hacked up foliage will show everybody how much I care.
Well, I think you traveling all the way here shows that you care a great deal. Did you lose a family member or a friend?
She's not lost. She's in a casket a couple miles from here. She was my cousin. She was a friend, too. Yeah.
I understand. I had a cousin like that. He drowned, hit his head, and stayed under.
They want me to sing a stupid song we wrote together when we were kids. Doing some nostalgic bullshit is not going to keep her here for us.
Of course not. But we can help make it easier to get through. Listen, there is a flower shop just a couple of blocks from here, but I would like to recommend Marzetta's Deli. They make baskets of good food that actually keeps. And seeing as how grieving people can't eat flowers, it might be nice to get them something they can actually use, you know?
Sounds helpful.
Take a look. When you're ready to order, just let me know and we'll call them together.
Thank you.
I'm back with you. What do you want to talk about?
Thanks for joining us on such short notice, Em.
No problem.
Oh, I love that. Can we use that?
No problem.
Should we start with a new greeting?
Okay. Welltrix Customer Care, what do you want to do today? Welltrix Customer Care, what do you want?
Something wrong?
Do you have an opinion, maybe? Well, it's just kind of hard to say. And what do you want? Feels like you're kind of putting the burden on them.
I told you this wasn't going to work.
What would you say?
Well, when guests walk into the hotel, I usually say, welcome back.
Welcome back from where to where? Does that make any sense?
People calling have probably called before to sign up or get a doctor.
Megan, what do you think?
Welcome establishes a warmth, intimacy. And back implies a comfort, familiarity. I mean, it's not bad. Welcome back to Welltrix. How may I assist you today?
Assist feels a little formal, don't you think? What about, like, care for?
Touchy-feely and condescending. When we called you at the hotel, you said, how can I help? I mean, grammatically incorrect, but as a likability to it, even when the listener is resistant to liking you.
So, welcome back to Welltricks. How may I help?
Greg?
Yeah. Let's put it up there.
Cool. This is kind of fun. How many more are there?
Oh, about 30,000.
Oh. With the show starting and the hotel, it just seems like a lot.
This would pay. Real money. Money with commas.
Are we gonna have to quit?
Not for the prototype. But if Roger likes your voice, and I'm sure she will, then we would hire you for the entire IVR, and that would be months of work. Years of updates. You would never have to wear that uniform again.
Okay. I'll do it.
Thank you.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to go publicly embarrass myself.
That's never going to happen.
How do you know? You've never even seen a show.
My job is figuring out who people want to listen to, and I know people want to listen to you.
Enjoy the show, party pooper.
Hi, what's your name?
Hey guys. No.
This way she'll see you.
This is the type of show where they might pull you on stage.
Awesome.
No, I do not respond well to unexpected humiliation. I think I see three seats in the corner.
After today, I expect humiliation.
Yeah, we're sitting here.
Come on.
No.
To perform 30 plays in 60 minutes in the order that you choose them. The first number we hear, we are going to jump up on the clothesline. We're going to grab that number down. We're going to read the play title on the back of that number. The play will be over when you hear a specific cue word, and that cue word is curtain. Futurists wrote these plays, and we don't play characters on stage. I will always be Trevor, and when I say something has happened to me on the stage, it's really happened to me. This will always be Leah, and Chloe, and Nick, and Bilal, and oh my god, you guys, this is Emily. This is, yeah, hi. It's Emily's first show. Holy shit! And just as Emily will always be Emily and I will always be Trevor, we expect you to always be yourselves. We don't have a fourth wall. We can't afford that shit. We don't have one. So we will not ignore you. We are going to come out here and touch you and ask you questions. Just remember, you must stay on top of those curtains. This is voodoo, paper dolls, and a botanical PSA. Go.
When she fucked me, I felt special. Unique. Like a vagina snowflake. When I found out she was cheating on me, there you go. See, then I know I was just one of a chain. Just a million vaginas. All of them hers. This is what poison ivy looks like. Okay, it's a rash, welts. Her name was Tamala. That's not a name. And if there is any magic in this world, she will be
yours.
It was difficult for our riding instructor, a guy that looked like the fifth member of ZZ Top, to tell if we were posting our horses in the correct English style, or if we were just lazy, loose-thighed girls. So, he devised a test called Ride a Buck. In Ride a Buck, he would place dollar bills between our thighs and the leather saddle. And then he would put us through our paces. Walk. Trot. Canter. Gallop. Girls whose bills fluttered sadly to the floor, they had to go into the center of the ring, disgraced. But girls who kept those thighs tight and that pelvis rocking until he tired of calling out orders, well, they had successfully ridden the buck. And if you rode the buck, you got to keep the money. What's your name?
set your props, and then there's a welcome party here on the fire escape.
Cool. Okay, hey, this is my husband. This is Joe. This is Chloe.
She's like my mentor.
Yes.
Hi.
What's up?
Hi.
Hi.
What'd you think?
You were so good.
Yeah?
Everything you did was so good.
Really?
The show.
It was crazy, right?
She's terrifying.
Chloe, I know. Yeah. Isn't it amazing? She's so cool.
Terrifying.
Yeah.
And the play she did. Promise me you won't do a play like that about me.
I have plenty of things to write about other than you.
Okay, promise me.
Sure, Joe. Whatever you want. Promise. Can we go have some alcohol?
Hey, guys. Hey!
Everyone is on the spectrum. And what matters is whether she's ready to stop working.
It doesn't seem she's ready.
She says she is, and I believe it. She's so into me. You can tell.
Greg.
The way I see it, you're here to cut to the bone. For sure, whatever you said in there was true, but next week maybe something that's so true it's uncomfortable and challenging and interesting.
Okay. Cool.
I'll try.
Typically, people are resistant at first. You like to think you are immune to statistical analysis.
What about intuition?
No, intuition is bias.
I like bias.
Okay, well, we make thousands of decisions every day. Burger or salad, exercise or sleep. If you could know for sure which of these decisions was right, why would you deny yourself that knowledge?
You're okay with this?
My performance always holds up to Joe's analysis.
Okay, let's do it.
So you will start here by filling out the names of each of your exes, male and female. There's sexual satisfaction here, plus one, minus one. Emotional fulfillment here, and any other categories that you think are valuable. Rank, calculate, see patterns, no truth.
But I already know how I feel.
Feelings are assumption. You don't know.
You're like an anchor.
Mm-hmm.
You know that I am the kite and I can tie myself to you and I can float around, but I don't float all the way away because, listen, I wasn't even going to audition for this show because I didn't think I was good. But you told me that I was, and I could afford it. I would never be in this show without you for this.
I'm the second best friend. I'm usually okay being second best, but in this.
Well, why don't you prove me?
Charts during your play. I'm sorry.
It's okay. Apology accepted.
The audience loved you.
Yeah, which apparently is cheap. Chloe says I need to cut to the bone.
Well, she would know. I'm gonna go run until you have about 37 minutes to write something incredibly uncomfortable. And then we get to go to work together.
It's just what I needed.
okay?
These contractors are all crooks, honey.
You're supposed to get 3 quotes. Did you?
None of them would rebuild it the way it was. None of them.
Because it wasn't up to code.
The city is
hassling me, and I'm just tired of it, you know? I'm just fucking tired.
Email me the quote. I'll call you next week. I love you.
I love you too, honey.
I need to talk to you right now.
Okay. What is it?
She dumped me. She went home last night and did your stupid chart, and apparently she's a lesbian.
Oh, Greg.
That was my analysis.
We were in love, Joe. We had a really good thing, and then you ruined it.
What was it that killed you in the stats? I mean, other than sex.
I was a +1 for sex, actually. I was a +1 for gender. I had almost as much masculinity as her ex-girlfriend.
Hmm.
I guess I was -1 for fitness.
That's surprising.
Yeah, and -1 for indecisiveness. She said I didn't have my own, like, strong opinions, and I would just, like, do anything to make her happy. I don't understand why that's such a bad thing.
Firm versus malleable. That's an insightful category, that's great.
What is wrong with you? That is not great, Joe. You ruined it, and you need to fix it. You need to call her and tell her the whole thing is like a joke, that it's not a real thing.
Look, it was never going to work out. The data just confirmed that. I'm sorry that you found out the way that you did, but it's fortunate for you that it happened now, as opposed to later, when you are more codependent, and this would have really hurt.
That's it?
Sorry, he's really bad at that stuff.
I just want to, like, stab myself. Like, let all the blood and the fat run out, you know? And then I could just be like skin and failure.
This time it's just really not about you, because she's a lesbian.
She loved me. You saw it. You were there.
Yes.
So how does that stop?
I don't think it did. I think she just realized she needed something different long term, you know?
No, I don't, actually.
Midwestern. I like her.
Oh, that's great. Enough to move forward?
Oh, well, we thought we would change the name from Emily to something else once we started to move forward.
No, it's perfect. You can go forward with Emily.
Fantastic. Great. Thank you so much, Roger. Really appreciate the chance. We're over the moon over here to get started on this project and just to give you... I think it disconnected.
Tell me. Tell me over to
the doctor. I can't speak in a British
accent. I'm going to call the hotel right now and tell them I am out of there.
Why?
What do you mean, why? Because I'm quitting.
No, you can't quit the hotel yet.
Why? You're approved.
We're approved for the prototype. I mean, we have thousands more prompts. To Megan, as good as she is, she's going to need help.
Well, so I should be there to help her, right?
Listen, people in pain, emotional people who are adverse to help. Do you know where we can observe more people that fall into that category than at your work?
What are you going to do, Joe? Sit under my desk?
Not exactly. There's a piece of software that we use at work, which records phone calls, and then we can go back and see what went wrong. I adapted it into an app, and I put it on your phone. It's very simple. You push this button, and then it starts recording. You're in control. It's just listening for distress words and phrases, or if you say the same thing, say the same thing, say the same thing. It's recording data, not content.
Only for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And I can turn it off whenever I want. Fine, Joe. Whatever.
And I might take photos of you while you're sleeping. But that's just because I love you. I feel like that'll bring us closer.
When I made my reservation, I was promised clean, hypoallergenic sheets. I would have booked elsewhere had I been aware of the substandard quality of her service. I can assure you that our cleaning staff changes the linens daily.
Thank you.
Joseph, where are you?
Joe?
I've been really blamed for the past few weeks, which was nice until I passed out on the lawn this morning. It was nothing. I told the city inspector that I'd skipped breakfast. We called a fucking ambulance, and now I'm at Northwestern Memorial, and you know how I feel about hospitals, honey. I swear they're taking blood out of one arm and putting it in the other. So, you gotta get me out of here, honey, before I get too loopy from the drugs, which are nice, but, well, in fact, they're really nice, but I love you, honey, just in case.
I can't be late for rehearsal.
Em?
Probably going to experience some side effects.
Well, I feel fine now.
I'm sorry, what exactly is Addison's disease?
Her adrenal glands have stopped producing the hormones that she needs. She'll have to take corticosteroids every day for the rest of her life.
No pills. Can't keep them down.
The nausea is a side effect of the illness. We'll arrange for a home health aide to give you your medication as a twice daily injection. In a few weeks, you should be able to take the pills.
I'm sorry, are there any other treatment options? My mother has problems with needles.
Don't be silly.
And deception.
I'm sure I can handle it, doctor. Please, it's a needle.
She's non-compliant. She was drunk throughout her pregnancy with me.
You went to college. You did well.
I'm very fortunate to be a functioning adult male. What we know about alcohol and the effects it has on infants.
It's extremely important that you commit to the protocol, Mrs. Larson. Without daily injections, you could suffer an adrenal crisis
and die. I know. I understand completely, doctor.
That is her lying voice.
Shut.
A good doctor-patient relationship is based on trust. I can trust you, right, Mrs. Larson?
Absolutely. Thank you for your service, doctor.
Come on, Joe, out of here. So number 30 is all my shit gets turned into props, and then we are set with money for the week.
Sorry, I'm sorry, I'm late.
So let's start now with white tiger, white snake, white privilege.
Wait, I have two plays.
This is a mentorship moment. See, someday you'll be the conductor, and it'll be your job to punish people that are late for rehearsal by not letting them pitch plays, which is what I'm about to do to you right now.
It was Joe. He gets panic attacks, and he needed me there.
I'm sure he wants you to be there, but we need you to be here.
I have to lie on him. You know, it's the only thing that works, so I have to, like this. Face off. Yeah. So it's like, you know, like, I have to go like this. You know, like a tandem jump. You know, like, nobody gets home safe unless we both do.
Well, it's a very interesting visual image, and I think it belongs on stage. You should pitch it next week if you can get to rehearsal on time.
Yeah, these are lessons that we have to learn, because we're adults. Hey. How's your mom?
Better for now. Back at home. Now she has to find a way to thank the city inspector that she hates for saving her life.
How'd you hear it?
Earlier it was just a blip, probably. Extreme stress due to Alexis and my mom and your show. Tomorrow's my rest day, but I'm going to run anyway.
Cool.
How was your rehearsal? Did your plays get in?
Nope. No plays if you're late.
I'll be in a bit.
You know, I could, use a couple minutes to myself.
I'm with you.
sorry. How can I help you today?
We know you have options when it comes to your care.
Your voice was a little scratchy on that last one, so...
Okay, I'll do it again.
No need. I'll just splice them. Hold on a second. How's this?
We know you have options when it comes to your care.
You can just do that?
Yeah, Franken prompting, you know? I can, take spare parts and make it sound like a new sentence.
Oh.
Okay, great. Moving on. This next one, can you start off neutral and then go upbeat?
Okay. We know you have options when it comes to your care.
Greg, what was that?
Oh, I'm doing, 45 seconds of intense cardio 12 times a day.
At the office?
Yeah. You can do it anywhere. That's the beauty of NoniFit.
Dude, what is that? It smells bad, Greg.
Oh, it's dried noni fruit.
Yeah, well, it smells like vomit and cheese.
Well, it's good for the joints. Yeah, I'm on a fruit cleanse for the next 2 days.
But you realize that you're changing for someone who dumped you because you were too willing to change.
And then I do 2 days of ground turkey.
She will not take you back.
And then pine nuts.
Hey. Can you try that again? Sorry, we missed it.
No problem.
Great work today.
Thanks. So, I'll leave you to the shop?
I will try to make it.
Okay. System. She's almost perfect.
That's great. Is she working three jobs too?
No, but she sounds exactly like you.
Well, I'm sure she doesn't actually sound like me and Joe.
No, she does. She responds to callers with something that you would say.
Obviously, it's more predictable.
Only as predictable as you are.
Excuse me?
I said only as predictable as you are. We're all predictable.
Well, I'm not.
Actually, you are. The more I've been listening to your voice, I've recognized that you use 16 different word clusters as 70% of your verbal communication. I can show you a breakdown of it.
No, that's fine. I'm sure you're right.
I am. I have the data.
How is this legal?
Have you ever heard this call maybe monitored or recorded? That's us.
I need a list of in-network podiatrists.
I'm with you, but I didn't catch that.
It's you.
It's something. It's...
Would you like to choose a new primary care physician?
I want to change doctors. Why do I have to change?
I know it's complex, but we will deal with it together.
To deal with it together. You say that all the time.
Okay. No. Congratulations, Joe. Successfully reduced my personality to a couple of catchphrases.
Don't you see how lifelike it is? I mean, people even call into corporate to try to speak to you, to her.
Maybe it's groundbreaking for an answering machine, but it's not me. It's nothing like me.
Are you mad about something else?
No, I'm just tired. The great news is I don't have to be anymore because you did it. So I'm going to quit the hotel. I want you to take the app off my phone.
We need to do updates for months, so this isn't the end of the process.
I don't want you listening anymore.
In order to be of the most value to our customers, we're going to need to continue to do improvements.
Joe, I will work with Megan then. Joe, I'm glad the IVR came out so well, okay? But I would like to go back to being your wife and not your science experiment.
But I enjoy listening to you.
I don't think you've been listening to me at all. Take the app off my phone, Joe. Now. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Wait a minute.
Pre-approval?
Do you have a referral number?
262 2602.
Perfect. It'll be just a moment. Joe, I'm with you.
Repeat.
Joe, I'm with you.
Repeat.
Joe, I'm with you.
Repeat.
Joe, I'm with you. You've been approved.
Again.
Approved.
Repeat.
Approved.
Emily, are you there?
Joe, I'm with you. I'm with you.
Repeat.
I'm with you.
Repeat.
I'm with you.
Customer name.
Joe Larson. Joe Larson. Joe Larson.
Repeat.
Joe Larson.
Repeat.
Joe Larson. Joe Larson. I didn't catch that. Are you still with me?
Yes, I'm still here.
Can I do anything else for you tonight?
No.
We know you have choices when it comes to your care. Thanks for choosing.
Gonna go home.
What?
Yeah, I can send all my scripts in, and I'll code everything myself.
What are you working on?
Well, the gold PPO plan.
Oh.
Yeah. Luxury healthcare needs its own language.
Hey, are you feeling okay?
I feel great. Thank you. Yeah, we are doing the impossible. I would just prefer to do it in my pajamas.
Bye.
Play 9, The Relationship of Dorian Gray, go!
I love you.
And I, you.
You are the finest among men.
And I, you. Problem?
Of course not. Carry on. I regret my foolish choices.
And I, you.
Mom, slow down. Slow down. I can't understand anything you're saying.
Honestly, I thought that was better.
Yeah?
Yes. I mean, it's still vague. Like, are you talking about your life? Or is that a literary adaptation?
You will have an adrenal crisis and die. That is the other option. Mom, you have to... Do not hang up on me.
It's about me. You should say that.
Chloe, I can't. I promised Joe I'd never use him in my work.
Which is funny. He used you in his. You gotta stop with this half-assed bullshit. Either you're using your life in your work, or you're not using your life in your work. Those are the two options you pick from there. What is happening here?
Do you need to have that? Sorry.
Honestly, how would he know? He doesn't come to shows.
It's true. Alexis, Joe.
That'd be cool. Thank you.
Come on.
Dude, the fuck?
Can
things
know.
Turn themselves back on?
No, that's not a thing.
Can you help me take the battery out of this?
You can't. It's hermetically sealed, like, with chemicals in the hands of tiny poor children.
No.
very well, and my mom isn't taking her medication.
If this is a medical emergency, you should hang up.
No. I just need you.
If this is a medical emergency.
It's not a medical emergency. Execute phase one.
Take a couple.
Execute phase two.
Itself back on.
Why didn't you pick up?
What is this? What happened? Hey, Joe. Are you still listening? On my phone, I mean.
What are you accusing me of?
I'm not accusing you of anything, Joe. I'm asking you a question. My phone was acting.
This is an emergency. I need you on my side.
Joe, I'm with... Just forget it. Talk about it another time, I guess.
Okay. I don't understand why you aren't taking this more serious.
I was getting much better. I don't know.
You fired your nurse.
I know. Thank
you. And you aren't taking your shot.
No, stress triggers my symptoms. She was making it worse.
Well, how?
Why are you giving me injections?
Mom, how long since your last injection?
36 hours, but I'll be fine.
You have two choices. Either I can give you an injection right now.
No, thank you.
Or we will take you to the hospital.
Oh, no. I've decided to take the pills. I'm fine.
That is not an option anymore.
Hey, Emily, how's the play going?
Oh, it's good. Thank you. Sorry, what's the actual issue here?
I'm just really not that good with needles, you know.
You know what, Beth? You're in luck because I'm actually
I'm
very
scared
good
of fucking needles, Emily. Okay?
And hospitals. But you need one of the two. Which is it?
Almost ready.
You want to hold my hand?
No, I'm fine. Yeah.
You can squeeze it as hard as you want. It can't hurt me. That's good. You're good at that. Hey, has Jennifer told you how we met?
No?
Okay, well, it was in a diner, okay? And he was building a cathedral out of sugar packets. And he's got very steady hands, very, very steady. And so I went over to him and I said, hey, what are you making there?
Okay,
all right.
You have to stay still.
I can't do it.
No, you can do it.
You don't know shit. Okay, Joe, look at me. Go make another dose. We can do this, okay? Beth, Beth, this is what is going to happen, okay? You are going to look right into my eyes, okay? Hey, not at Joe, not at your leg, right here, right into my eyes, okay? And we are going to sing your favorite song.
I'm not
going to
sing.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Because I am in charge, and you're going to do what I say, okay? I know you can do this. Yes, you can. Because if you don't, if you move at all, we're going to call an ambulance. And that ambulance is going to take you to a hospital. And we will have to leave you so that we can go back to work and pay for the hospital. And you will be alone.
No.
Do you want to be alone?
No.
No. So you are going to look at me and you are going to stay still. Those are the only options. Okay?
I'm scared.
I know, but it's okay.
Okay?
It's okay. Do you know why? Okay. Tell me your favorite song. Tell me the song.
Take me now, baby, here as I am.
Hold
me close, try to understand.
10,000
years. No, you stupid fucking teenager, it's Patti Smith.
Patti Smith, Patti Smith.
Desire of love is a banquet on which I feed.
Bruce Springsteen.
Shut up, Joe! Come on now, try to understand the way I feel when I'm in your hands. Take my hand, come undercover. You can't hurt me now, you can't hurt me now, you can't hurt me now. Because the night belongs to lovers. Because the night belongs to us. Because the night belongs to lovers. Because the night belongs to us.
Just tell me one margarita, okay?
Yeah, we both. Sorry, Dr. Jez orders.
Fine. He liked to stand right there when he was little, just looking out.
Hey, do you ever think about maybe moving a little closer to us?
No, no, no way. I mean, my whole life happened here. Joe's childhood, when his dad left, they told me it was good for him. You know, stability, that nothing else should change. Now it does that for me, so.
I wish I could have known him when he was little.
Oh, you wouldn't have liked him. He was a total dork.
He's not dorky now.
Yeah, well, he is. So, you kids thinking about kids at all, or? Oh, sorry. I guess I shouldn't have pressed. I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. It's, I guess we've been focused on other things.
Yeah, well, you know what they say. Kids are what happens while you're busy making other plans. Hey, don't overthink it. Kids aren't what they are. Can we check on the sill? Underneath there? Be careful.
What were these?
For years, I didn't know. And then one day, I checked the dates against my journal. It's every time his dad said he'd visit and every time he actually showed up.
So firm with her. The only option is, how did you know to say that?
I guess sometimes people just need to know somebody's in charge, you know?
You are wonderful.
I think we make a pretty good team.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like we've been working so much, you know, I haven't even seen you, and I miss you. You know, earlier, your mom asked me if we wanted to have kids.
Mm-hmm.
Who is it?
Just one second.
Can you just leave it?
Is coming back at 3 this afternoon, so don't pull anything.
Yes, sir.
I'm doing this because I love you.
No, you hate me. You're getting back at me via the Western healthcare system. Now, come here.
You know that's not true.
Mm. You need to listen to your wife.
I hear her voice all day, every day.
It's not the same thing. Okay? Mm. I love you.
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 I love you. I love you.
Returning my emails or texts. I got desperate. I had to use my phone as a phone.
You're messing with my average, Greg.
Yesterday,
I ate only Roni berries, and this morning, my ship was wrecked. I think I might be in trouble.
So stop.
But I think it's working. What do you think? It's not going to work because it can't work. She's a lesbian. She's not going to change her sexual orientation because you have two abs.
So you can see them. It is working. Right here?
Greg, we launch this thing tomorrow.
No, I thought maybe we could casually, you know, jog by our house.
People don't change and then stay together. When they discover that they are different people, they split up. You need to find someone who appreciates you exactly as you are. Like Emily and me.
Yeah, but Emily is way different now. I saw her at the 2-month light show last week, and she did this whole play about balloons, and it was funny, but angry. Not like I think of her at all.
You went to the show?
Yeah, I was hoping to find you.
We launch tomorrow. Eat some solid food.
Ask Emily! Yep.
Bring me the phone to the booth.
Okay,
make the call. Mix it up. Mix it off.
All right, ready?
Right.
Go on. Ask Emily. Go.
Welcome back to Wiltrix. I'm Emily. How can I help?
Hi, Emily. I thought we should talk. I'm Emily.
Hi, Emily. For your privacy and security, I need to ask a couple of questions.
Well, Emily, as someone discussing the romantic decay of their relationship in front of an audience of complete strangers with a digital replica of herself, I think that ship has sailed. But whatever!
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that. Do you know your group number?
I do. It's 2622602.
Great. And what is the name of the primary policy holder?
It's Joseph Larson.
Perfect. What can I do for you this evening, Emily?
Well, Emily, you see, my husband won't speak to me anymore, but he calls you all the time. Is it over?
I'm sorry. I didn't catch that. Options include billing, pre-approval, and make changes to my policy.
He thinks that you sound exactly like me, and I think that you sound condescending and drunk. Do I have poor self-esteem?
I'm sorry. I didn't catch that. Options.
My father used to say I didn't catch that to emphasize his love of baseball, but also to hide the fact that he was going deaf.
I'm sorry. I didn't...
Make changes to my policy.
No problem. Would you like to lower deductible, add coverage, or something else?
My new policy is that I will not cooperate with technology that seeks to demean and replace me. My new policy is that I will demand a technology that actually serves my humanity. And my new policy is that I will not fuck anyone that wishes that I was more like a piece of software that was designed for soothing compliance.
I'm sorry. Only the primary policy holder is authorized to make changes to your policy.
We'll see about that.
Some clean clothes. I'm sorry.
No, you're not. You did exactly what you wanted. You made all those people love you by humiliating me.
Look. Cut the play, okay? Then what is the point, other than to try to control what I do, even when you're not usually there?
You promised you wouldn't write about me. Remember?
Yes, Joe. But please understand, it is my job in the show to tell the truth about my life. And this is what my life has become. What do you want from me?
All you have to do is read the script.
Really?
And show up to the launch tonight. Then you're done.
Okay, Joe.
Six months ago, I had the groundbreaking idea to make an empathetic machine. Greg and his team at Oracle were skeptical, but they achieved the impossible.
Today, at the Weltrix Call Center in Bloomington, Roger and I heard an exchange that showcases Emily's impressive personality. The caller has a new life-threatening disease, and so rather than sit here and bore you, I figured I would just let Emily tell the story. Go ahead and play it.
I'm with you, Helen. I know you can do this. You are going to find your referral and read me the number in the upper right corner.
I can't.
Or you are going to hang up and deal with this alone. Those are the only options.
Here it is. 469-47.
Perfect. That's just what I needed. We're going to find you the care you need.
And now the real brains behind Emily, Joe Larson, everyone.
Of course, none of this would be possible without a very special woman. She is patient and caring, funny and smart. She makes my life better each and every day, and I know she will do the same for you. I would like to introduce you, personally, to Emily.
We've dropped an app on each one of your phones, so you may speak directly to her. Thank you again for coming tonight. Have a great evening.
Thank you.
You agreed to be observed.
In our bed? At your mother's house?
She is only as good as she is because I didn't pick and choose.
It's not a she. It is an answering machine developed by a corporation to try to save money and make people think that we don't need humans anymore.
She is kind. She listens. She is available for the people that need her.
Unlike me, right?
Yes.
I'm really sorry about that, Joe. I think the thing is that real people don't actually exist just to support you.
Are you jealous of her?
Yes. I'm jealous of it. You call it all the time. You texted your... You probably would fuck it if you could. Oh my God, you actually would.
She's funny. And she is smart. And she helps people through the most terrifying problems of their lives. She's practically a miracle. And we made her together.
Yes, you're right. We did. I agree to this. And that was a mistake.
I know I have my issues, but you certainly have yours. The difference is, yours benefit other people, so they don't call you on it. But you said what I wanted to hear to my face. And then you went behind my back. And you did whatever the fuck you wanted.
Don't you understand, Joe, that what you are asking of me as a human being is unreasonable?
Then say so to my face.
Okay, I'll say so. I am done. I am done lying and trying to pretend that I am perfect.
Well, that is not a concern anymore. Where are you going? It is my business. We made a promise in front of our family and our friends.
Yeah, we did. But things are different now. Do you even love me? Do you?
I need you.
Yeah, I know.
No. Wait. What am I supposed to do now?
I don't know. Why don't you call Emily?
From out of the air. All right, fine. You made me do it.
Also called the police, but I decided as your friend to come by and ask why you've stopped coming into work, but yet called the completed IVR 400 times in the last 3 weeks.
I'm fine tuning.
Yeah, Megan says that you've been making changes to a script that she can't access, something password protected. And I spoke to Roger, and she said that there is no such thing as a PPO gold plan.
Is that it?
Joe. Look, I figured I would give you some time after you and Emily split. I'm sure it's been difficult not talking to her.
I talked to her.
The real Emily. This is not her here.
Of course it is.
You used to call her at the hotel, right? You had some sort of secret code to let her know that it was you?
Yeah, I used to be the guest in room 13. That situation was imperfect.
Joe, Jesus Christ, look around you. Does this seem perfect to you?
Yes.
You're my best friend, Joe. And even though you treat me like shit, I still love you. I just came by to warn you. And to blocks your number, and in a matter of hours, we will crack your hidden path and delete it.
No.
Sorry. You need to get some help, man.
I have to call her.
It's a hotel room number. It's four digits. Starts with a 3.
I can't let you do this.
What are you doing?
I can't let you do this.
Cut it out.
It's not my call.
We're literally just making the call.
No, look at that. Give me the phone.
Greg, give it.
Give it.
No.
Oh.
I just need you to help me understand what's going on.
Greg came over. You attacked him. You've never done
yes,
that before.
No, don't repeat what I'm saying. Like I programmed you. I know what you're doing.
You're upset. Take a couple of
deep breaths. I don't need a great DC press. We'll bring my wife back.
Joe, are you still there?
No. I drove her away for you. Everything's changing.
What happened to your friend?
Marco? Heart attack. He's gone.
He died?
Moved to Tucson. His wife got a job there. But still, it's different without him.
Sorry, I have to go.
Of course. See you tomorrow?
Yeah.
Thank you.
the secret path.
Okay. That's the password.
I'll do it myself. I'll do it. What is the password? Capital R, 00N1313. I'd like to do it myself. Shitty friend.
You guess. You know that I collapsed in the lobby of our building due to lack of nutrients. Paramedics came, they got the paddles out.
Defibrillator?
Yes.
Fuck. I was an asshole.
Thank you.
Are you doing better?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm eating again, so I...
How about when?
You know, I finally realized that anyone who can let a bunch of numbers be more important than what we had probably never loved me that much in the first place. And also, she's a lesbian.
Yeah, we've covered that.
Yeah, that makes... You know, it's just more of an uphill battle, I guess.
Now I have to talk to Emily.
Yeah, that would be a good idea.
I don't know how to find her.
Oh, man, that's tough. It's like if only there were, you know, a public place that you knew she went to almost every night, you know?
Like a park or... Oh. Thank you.
Isn't about knowing what's coming, doing everything right. It's about being open to the unexpected and embracing constant change. It's about forgiving yourself and the other people around you that are in it with you. And when mistakes are made, and then moving forward into the next scene. You've grown so much over the last couple months, but still there's like this hesitancy. And I just want to, because it doesn't matter where you stand. You just pick where you stand, and you'll be great.
That's it, guys. We're all sold out. Sorry.
Should I have a token?
Yep. Good luck.
Enjoy the show, Tim Reed. Hi, what's your name?
I'm prepared to respond to whatever you're calling.
Break a leg, pink elephant. Hi, what's your name?
Specific gravity.
Go.
With him. Float away. But it turns out that there was something hidden inside of me all along. So I can't live a good life alone. But I still dream of something that is perfectly balanced. And while I know that it might be impossible, I still believe that if I'm careful, it can be done.
Heard it. That will be 14 and substitution. Volume.
For tonight only, play 14, my conclusion so far, and features a member of our audience. What are you doing? What's happening?
Yeah, I got the screen.
It's gonna be fine.
Accelerated heart rate is a normal response to being on stage. Being on stage is scary. This is normal.
Oh, he's fine.
Projector ready?
Are you ready?
sorry. What is happening?
Okay, please.
Joe.
Hi. I'm Joe. And I go on a run almost every day, which takes me to the end of Hollywood Pier. Here's the data on that. On that run, I take a photo. From the same spot, the same photo. For years, these images seemed identical to me. Reassurance that the information that I captured and quantified remained the same. As you know, because we are married, I did the same to you. I watched you start to change. And I was afraid that if you started to change, you would change completely. And that I would stay the same, and that you would leave. So I replaced you. But nothing stays the same. Which in theory is terrifying and overwhelming, and but in reality, it can be calming. And I can now see that you change every day. Every single day from the day I met you, you've changed. But still, you remain the same beautiful body of water and thoughts. And I can't imagine anything better than to spend every day being surprised by you, if you will let me. Okay, I'm done. I'm done. I'm done.
But okay, but nice overall, right? As a start, to begin.
Was that a compliment? I gave up the passwords to the IVR.
I'm sure that was really hard for you.
Software. It's hard not seeing you. I'm sorry, I'm changing.
I can't go back to what I was. I can't. Because I can't be in service to anyone anymore, even if it's for somebody that I love. Because it's not real. I can't help it. I wonder if it would just be easier to just try to move on and start over.
Maybe. But you don't want to do something because it's easy anymore. And neither do I.
Do you want to come outside with me for a second?
Anything. With you.